Hey everybody, should have actually prepared more. So I'm gonna be making a video, the rise and fall of the FAMAS and Call of Duty. This video's been anticipated for a really long time. Really should have looked at the date that I made that post, but I think I made another video when I was happy that I made, no, I think I was depressed, and then I guess I just posted iron sights for the FAMAS. You know how I usually do this. You get the iron sights of each game it was in, and then you have the gun at the end. Yeah, I don't think I did so good on some. If you're wondering how I get those things, they're pretty simple. You look up the gun. That's kind of weird. You look up the gun on Google Images, you find the best looking one. I tried looking for one that isn't blocked in the back or just has a plain white or black background. It shows a gun a lot, and I just cut it down in like photos. Okay, other than that, I think I'm just wasting time. So we're gonna talk about the rise and fall of the FAMAS. I'm thinking I'm making two videos today. One talk about some weird guy on YouTube, and the one we're doing now. So let's start with how the FAMAS was. It was originally gonna come into Call of Duty 4, but it was cut. I think there's maybe they talked about it in the campaign. I didn't play the campaign since I actually hate COD 4 or Modern Warfare 1. It's an incredibly boring game. Okay, so, and then it comes back in it first appears in Modern Warfare 2. It's kind of a decent gun. It gets beat easily by an M16. It has 30 rounds. It's a 3-round burst. It has really crappy iron sights. It's like the first 3-round burst gun you get, but it's easily beat by the M16, as I said. But this is its first appearance, so you can give her credit for that. So the FAMAS basically is all around just M4A1, but as a 3-round burst. And then the next game it was in Black Ops 1. I actually almost forgot about that. Black Ops 1 is incredibly overrated, I'll tell you that. It's not really the best game. I played it. And for some reason on Xbox, I got used to the Field of View 110. It's like 60 on there. It's like this. But yeah, so it's an automatic gun around, but it's a little better. I heard that it's basically the best gun, which I disagree, which is the Galil. But in Black Ops 1, it has 30 rounds. It's fully automatic this time around. It has exactly the same iron sights, or to an extent, it sucks. And I try using it online, but Wi-Fi connection thing on there just sucks. It's like Modern Warfare 3 to an extent. You get like 4 shots on the FAMAS in that game online. You literally need 50. You need like maybe 16 shots to kill somebody, but maybe I can join a match where the host is me or someone whose Wi-Fi isn't made of buttered bread. But yeah, I played with it offline. I play on bots, and it's actually pretty good. I didn't play like today at all. I remember like, I think 3 months, 3 or more months, nah, probably like 6 months ago. I was playing on Black Ops 1, and I killed a couple bots. It was a really good gun. It's really high fire rate, really good damage. I heard it was better. I guess they nerfed it and added recoil, which I barely notice sometimes. Unless I'm playing online, then the recoil is up to here. But yeah, it can. In both games, it can be increased to 45 rounds, you know. And, yeah, that's basically Black Ops 1's FAMAS. And then it was actually going to go into Modern Warfare 3, but it was replaced by a Type 95, which ended up being a way better 3-round burst rifle than it was in Modern Warfare 2. And then Black Ops 2, the FAMAS basically did not come back. It was basically thought of as being a DLC weapon when I tried looking for DLC pack names for a different thing. But yeah, and then Ghost came out, the FAMAS didn't come back, but there was like an MSNBC, which terrible, I forgot its name. Yeah, and that was basically the FAMAS in that game. Advanced Warfare didn't come back, and BO3, it actually did come back. I was going to talk about Call of Duty Online, but who plays that game? I literally can't. If I had a PC and an emulator, I would love to play Call of Duty Online. Hope it has an offline mode. So in Black Ops 3, it actually came back as a supply drop only weapon, which, you know, Black Ops 3 is pretty freaking terrible for that. Hey, let's have more than half the guns in supply drops. I don't want to pay money or play for 50 hours a day just to get a freaking supply drop. And most of those, you just get crappy camos, so why not? I actually did get kind of lucky once, and it was like months after I made that one supply drop, Black Ops 3 supply drop video, I got rid of it because it just had really bad memories to it. But yeah, I ended up getting lucky in a common supply drop. I got the A50, the A something A-Max. It's a pretty good LMG. you can't put extended mags on it, which I was pretty sad about. I wanted to put 70 rounds on an LMG that can literally just have infinite ammo. But then Infinite Warfare didn't come back. World War II, obviously not. Modern Warfare 4, actually, it brought it back, which is very odd, since it's supposed to be... Modern Warfare 4 is supposed to be more like the first game, but it's more like the second and third. Not gameplay style, because I literally got where's the dictionary when you need one? In Modern Warfare 4, it literally was, like, really good. It was, like, the highest it's ever been. You shoot someone, you can literally two-shot someone with a three-round burst gun in there. 30 rounds go up to 60 for some, because, you know, gunsmiths are a thing. And it literally just kills them. It's pretty good, actually. It's got great iron sights, way better than the ones previously. The BO3 one had unique iron sights, but not as good. That one's pretty good. Call of Duty Online had a 4-round burst from us. Oh. I hope that ain't my neck and ears, it's just the house. Sorry if my echoes kind of sound metallic, because either vocal cords or the dang house. Just does some dumb stuff, dude. Yeah, so Modern Warfare 4, it's really good, basically best ever. And guess what happens the next year? Call of Duty Cold War releases, we get the worst one ever. You get, the FAMAS had went straight to its highest, down to its lowest in a matter of 1 year. Call of Duty Mobile, I barely played with it, but when I did get it, I actually liked it. It's pretty good. It's like the Modern Warfare 4 one, but automatic. It only goes up to 39 rounds, which is really, really stupid. But yeah, they nerfed it in that capacity, but for Call of Duty Cold War, it's terrible. It starts at 25 rounds, which is the lowest it's ever been in the whole series. It does barely any damage. It shoots actually slower than it did in Black Ops 1. The time to kill is way too dang high. You have to shoot some guys 6 times just to get them down instead of 2, which is really horrible. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's the last gun you unlock in the base game, but the first 4 are better anyway, so... My fault then. It has way too high of a recoil, and the mags, and it reloads kind of slow. It reloads just as fast as the Type 95 in that game. Shut up. Yeah, it's probably the metal around me. So, in that case, you go from 34 rounds to 44, and that's the worst way to do extended mags, because it, no matter how high you want the magazine to go, it's just going to go lower than it did in like Black Ops 1. Actually, it's lower than every game before it, except for Modern Warfare Mobile. That was the only one that beat it. It starts at 30, ends at 39. This one starts at 25, goes to 44. And Warzone, I guess they fixed it a bit by having going from 34 to 38 and 44 to 50. Decent, I guess. It sucks all around. It's literally terrible. The iron sights are messed up. You literally have to put a reticle and extended mags on it just for it to work properly. Yeah, it sucks, Gerald, and I hope the next game it's in, they actually bring it back to full capacity and not give it, like, 20 rounds, has, like, unlimited fire rate, and has, like, the slowest reload in the world to do, like, 2 damage. Okay, I'll see you later. I'm gonna go make another video in a bit, maybe wait an hour or two. It's nearly nighttime. I wanted to do this earlier, but I guess I just got stuck in bed just listening to that good song I heard yesterday. It's called Rhythm of the Night. It's a pretty good song. Like, subscribe, okay.